Divine music is twofold. One kind exists entirely in the eternal mind of God. The second is in the swift and orderly revolution of the heavens, by which the heavenly spheres and their orbits make a marvelous harmony. In both of these, our souls took part before they were imprisoned in our bodies. 8 tones are produced by the motions of the 8 spheres, and a 9th, one great harmony, arises from all of them, and so we call the 9 sounds of the heavens the 9 muses. Through the ears, the soul receives the echoes of that incomparable music by which it is led back to the deep and silent memory of the harmony which it previously enjoyed. The whole soul then kindles with desire to fly back to its rightful home so that it may enjoy that true music again. It strives wholeheartedly to imitate it on various instruments and in song because it cannot here enjoy its possession. Remember that song has an extraordinary power to imitate everything, for it reflects the purpose, passion, and words of the soul. It also represents the gestures, movements, and actions of men and their characters. It sets forth all these with such power that it moves both the singer and the listeners to imitate them themselves. By the same power, when it reflects what belongs to the divine world, it raises our spirit up to divine influence in some marvelous way and brings the divine influence down to enter our spirit. When at the right hour you call out to the gods in song, they seem about to answer you like an echo or like a string in a kithara, trembling to the vibration of another which has been similarly tuned. The ancient theologians declare that souls slip into a body by descending through Cancer, the house of the moon, since they come with the desire to produce offspring into a region subject to generation. Hence they named Cancer the portal of mortals. Moreover, Orpheus says, "The moon is pregnant with the stars. The moon is queen of the stars." The moon has a voice, but no song.